Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name's Jenny and I have a website called mybritneyspearscollection.com. Hi to all the new subscribers and thank you so much for anybody who has stuck with me while I've been away. Now, I haven't actually been anywhere, just life has got in the way, so I'm really happy to come back to YouTube and show you more items from my collection. So in today's video, I'm showing you a magazine called Glamour. It's from 2003 and it's about Britney being the woman of the year and the truth about Justin, Colin and other dating rumours. I've actually let this magazine go recently out of my collection, so I wanted to share it with you guys because I don't have it anymore, but it's always nice to see it on video. Some of my items I've decided to just make a bit more room and let these go to other collectors who would appreciate them. So yeah, this is from 2003. This is 21 years old, but it's a really pretty picture of Britney. Now, obviously back in the day, they used to Photoshop a little bit. I think if you look a bit close, you can see where they have slightly Photoshopped her face, her shoulders, but otherwise it's still a really pretty cover. So opening up the page for the contents, you can see that she's the top story. And in the little editor section, it says you can win the cover look and get the same makeup that she's wearing in the photo shoot, and it gives you information about it's Vidal Sassoon and it's Estee Lauder makeup, and the photograph was done by Mark Little. As usual, just before I go any further, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell. That'll give you a notification every time I put a video up. So if I'm really sorry if it's really sporadic, but I'm going to try my best to put more videos up, but click the bell and then every time I put a video up, you'll get a notification. So I was just flipping through the magazine. It's all normal women's magazines, especially from 2003. It's a lot of makeup, it's a lot of horoscopes and fashion. And then you get to the Britney article. The Britney article itself was called Vrav Vrav Vroom, Britney on a Motorbike. And it says, Glamour, Woman of the Year. And I will try my best to read it for you as well if you can't read it. Stronger, sharper and definitely sexier, the brand new Britney, Glamour's Woman of the Year, talks to Joe Elvin about flirting, fashion and her future. And again, photo by Mark Liddell. So let's read this for you. It says, sipping lattes in a dimly lit room of a Hollywood recording studio, I realise I'm getting the first audience with the new Britney Spears. She definitely looks like the one we've all known since she burst onto the scene in 1998 with Baby One More Time. The pulled on jeans and baby pink cut off tee are regulation Britney, but after a few minutes it's clear something shifted in her. In the flesh, probably the most surprising thing about Britney is the steeliness behind that sugar spun sweetness. Okay, the voice is still bubbly and high pitched when she's excited about a topic, but there are also the moments when she pierces me with a stare and perfectly mimics my clipped English vowels. As she puts it, I think sometimes because I'm from the South, Kentwood, Louisiana, there's a misconception. Girls from the South are very nice, so people think we're pushovers, but you can get a lot further with a smile. We know what we're doing, you know? We know how to work it. It's about being a lady and getting what you want, not being too aggressive. Putting it mildly, the past year has been a wild ride for Britney Spears. Her split from Justin Timberlake was the world's most public since Tom and Nicole. Then, I mean being the bitch it is, this coincided with her parents' separation. Professionally, things were a little wobbly too. When US sales of her third album, Britney, were incredible, over 700,000 in the first week, as opposed to the bloody incredible for her second, oops, I did it again, over 1.3 million first week sales. Then, when she dared to make a fun, upbeat movie, instead of, say, a art house subtitled masterpiece, it sparked the sort of media tongue-lashing normally reserved for people who con old ladies out of their savings. But you get the feeling Britney realises this last year has been a liberation, both personally and professionally. After the normal period of heartbreak hibernation, Britney has emerged to find she actually loves being single. Single, really, for the first time in her adult life. She seems to have finally realised she's the hottest freaking babe on the planet. And the added bonus? The media obsession with the pesky virgin issue has waned. She smokes, she drinks, and like every other 21-year-old woman, so what if she has the odd casual snog? Hers just happened to be with really hot film stars. Later this year, she'll release what promises to be her most mature album to date. She's also considering new scripts for more challenging film roles. For all these reasons and more, Glamour's proud to give Pop's 21st Century Princess another crown, Woman of the Year. Although from the sound of it, the next 12 months and beyond will see Britney truly becoming her own woman. So the interview continues. So what have you been up to since the world last saw Britney Spears? And she says, I've been recording and reading scripts and I took a break. When I did Crossroads, I was everywhere in the media, so I wanted to slow down and give myself a chance to breathe. But when I did that, I got even more press. It was the news that I was taking a break and I've been dating and having fun. I used to be a little too much about the work. When did you last really cut loose? Last night, I went to a premiere with Colin Farrell. He's a doll. How well do you know Colin? I've known him for about 2 weeks now. We're just friends. It's nothing serious, but he's so hot. He's adorably cute. I didn't even watch the movie. Seriously, I don't know what it was about. I watched him the whole time and I'm like, holy crap, he is so cute. So when are you going out again? I don't know. He's Mr. Playboy, so we'll see. Are you going to call him? There's a time and a place to be aggressive with men. At the beginning, it's cool to let them know you're interested, to spark things, but I think men should call women. Last week, one of my girlfriends was calling one of my male friends and saying, call Britney, and I'm like, what are you doing? That's not how it works. Maybe, like me, she thinks a lot of men would like to call you, but you're so famous that you're scared to. I see what you're saying. It's weird because I'm probably more scared than they are. What's your side of the whole Justin thing? Is it true that you reacted to Justin's Cry Me a River by writing your own retaliation song? No, I would never do that. That was his way of dealing with what happened. Maybe that was his way of expressing himself and getting out there. I would never air his dirty laundry like that. So what's your take on the song? I think the way the whole thing went down when we broke up was a lot to deal with anyway, but it was just like 10 times with the whole freaking world watching. It was so overwhelming. And the way Justin played everything, being very clever by saying stuff like, I'm not saying anything but, and then he's writing a song and making a video, it's like, what are you talking about? So how did you feel seeing the video? Well, I was a little shocked and disappointed, but everybody has a side and their story, and he chose to tell the world his like that, and that's cool. I just don't want to be the person to go there. How was it at the American Music Award when the Osbournes were publicly teasing you both? From the stage, Sharon asked them why they couldn't work things out. I know I cringed for you. Britney laughs and says, that was a little awkward. But honestly, if you take it too seriously, it's going to really bug you. Justin's a great person. He's a wonderful person, but I'm not in how I used to feel for him at all. So it feels nice to be able to not really care. Is that a bad thing to say? Not at all. Do you feel kind of cleansed of it all now? Yeah, I think so. I just got an apartment in New York. I did everything up myself. It was right when we broke up. I was like, I rebelled, honey. I've got the most girly apartment ever. I love it. Shall we just confront the last rumor while we're at it? Fred Durst? We worked together on 3 songs. He's a great guy and he said some amazing things about me, but I think he leaped in too deep, too quick. I'm not there. I just want to have a good time. We're great friends. He's a really sweet guy. Was there anything romantic there? I think him for me, but not me for him. Has what you want in a relationship changed now? I'm a bit more open to people than I used to be. I don't want a serious relationship right now. Every relationship I've been in has lasted 4 or 5 years. I was that girl, you know? The one person girl. It's cool to be able to date just for fun. That really is the new you, isn't it? Yeah, it's cool because the guy I'm dating right now had that kind of thing in the past too. He went for the whole spiel with the breakup thing, so he also wants something light. Are we talking about Colin Farrell? I don't want to say. She whispers. So tell me about the new album you're working on. I'm really proud of what we've done so far. People are going to be surprised by some of my new work. It's so creative and out there and different. I have to have self-worth as an artist and do something that I believe in. What about your film career? I'm supposed to be doing a movie in April. I have to make a decision between 2 roles. One role is playing a kind of mentally disturbed girl. It's an amazing, challenging role, and I've never done anything like it, but that's also why I'm a little nervous about it. The character is not me. But I don't want to pass it up because I don't know if anybody would give me a role like that again. And then there's this other role that's like a Julia Roberts kind of thing, a fun romantic comedy. Does it frustrate you that people think they know you inside out? I think generally people see me as a sweet goody two shoes, and that's cool. At heart, that's who I am. But I do have a wild side. When you look at how powerful you are as a celebrity, do you ever want to do something really mad, like start a stupid fashion trend and just see what happens? Oh, I always play with people. I've gone to clubs in my PJs and everybody's like, hey, cool, she's wearing her PJs. And it's not cool. Yeah, you have to do stuff like that sometimes. Whose style do you like? Jennifer Aniston always looks very put together. I love that. But I have so many different sides. I like to be sophisticated sometimes, but then I love to dress like Gwen Stefani. She's the only one who can get away with it, though. I could never wear some of the stuff she wears. Well, you got away with your PJs. Oh, you're right. Okay, I tell you what I have done. I get the pantyhose tights and cut the crotch out of them. Oh my god, where's this going? No, seriously, listen to this. I've done this before. It's so no doubt. So you take the pantyhose, the fishnet kind, cut out the crotch and the top of the feet, pull them over your head, putting your head through the hole you made in the crotch, and you put your hands through the legs and pull the waist over the bra. It's the cutest shirt in the world. You should market it. I went out and got so many freaking pantyhose with all these different designs. I did that and it was off my whole wardrobe. It's a good idea though, you'd like it. Do you dislike anything about fame? Sometimes I really do wish I could not be famous, and people are like, but you love being on stage. And I do, and my time to be a performer is expressing yourself and having that feeling and that energy. But when I come off stage, I'm just me. Do celebs stick together because they're the only ones who can really understand that? I think you can to a certain extent, maybe relate to somebody, but actually, you know, that's bullshit. I disagree. There are so many shady, famous people in LA who are so weird. I'd probably have a better conversation with somebody working in McDonald's. I'm being honest right now, but it's so true. Don't get me wrong. There are some amazing people. Selma Blair, for instance, is a doll. Reese Witherspoon, she's amazing. But there are a lot of people in LA whose reality is stupid. How high maintenance are you? Oh, I'm very wash and go. Today I just wash my hair and put mascara on. Usually when I've been going places, I won't even blow dry my hair. I just go. My nails are... And then she says a bad word, which is not acceptable today. And unfortunately, people did say it back then. How do you see your career when you're, say, in your 30s? My fairy tale dream is to do it all. I would love to have a family. That's my main priority. And to do respectable movie roles. And do amazing music and perform in front of thousands of people. And do incredible live shows, because my music, especially my live stuff, is very showy. A lot of people don't respect it as an art. Well, it seems a lot of people just have a problem with a sexy woman, would you agree? Yes, I guess that people will say, oh, they're just pretty, they're just given a song, they're a puppet. Does that make you angry? A little bit, but I think because I'm young and soft-spoken, I'm nice to people, they go ahead and assume that. But everything I've ever done, even my movie, I helped write it. The whole idea came from me, all my shows and my tours and everything. They're all of me, and I'm so complete opposite to a puppet. It's really bizarre. She's right, it is bizarre. It's 9 p.m. when I say goodbye to Britney, and she's going back into the studio to meet up with the Neptunes. They're going to listen to what she's recorded and see if they could work on any of her new songs with her. Leave willing to bet a lot of money that an older, wiser and totally in control Britney will silence the cynics, every last one of them. So there you go guys, that's Glamour magazine from 2003. April 2003, Britney would have been 21. I would have been 21 as well. That's insane to think that so much time has passed. Obviously so much has changed in everybody's lives. Britney is out of the woods now, thankfully, and living her life, having a great time. And it's nice to see her interview where she's free, single, having a great time. So if anything, she's back to where she was, age 21 almost, so that's great to see. If you like this video, don't forget to leave me a comment, thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe if you like videos like this and want to see more items out of my collection, even if you want to see items I've let go. I'm really glad that I videoed it so we could both enjoy it. So I hope you like the video, and I will catch you on the next video. So take care, bye guys.